maybe picking up the last part first. We are a little confused in terms of the last, the point that I made during my presentation, that what is the conventional wisdom on this? US had the most fragmented regulation that you can imagine, and UK had the most integrated regulation that you can imagine. And it doesn't appear that the experience of these two countries was very different in this crisis. So which serves a country better? A fragmented regulation or a unified regulation? We really don't have an answer. And before the crisis, it appeared that the way to go was to go for unified regulation. Given the state of the real politics and the state of development in this country, I don't see regulation getting integrated in India. I think it will remain where it is. And I don't think it is such a bad thing. Your question was also about saving, that not enough savings going into risk capital. I think this is something that is also related to the demographic profile. And as more and more young people come into jobs where it gives them income that is beyond meeting just their necessities and they have sufficient savings, the participation in risk capital will increase. And India should expect that over the next 10 years, it will see a tremendous growth in the amount of savings that come into equity market if we get our regulation and the market design right.
Thank you. Now, on one hand, you mentioned that we fared well compared to the markets during the crisis period. On the other hand, you also mentioned that conventional wisdom may not work. But what I perceive is that we use more conventional wisdom than the other markets. Is that true?
Yes, sir. You're saying that conventional wisdom works?
Yeah, looks like that.
Okay, but I use the word conventional wisdom in terms of the fact that the practices in the Western markets were taken as conventional wisdom. And not only did they believe in it, we also believed in it. And we also thought that we need to catch up. This particular thing is not in my market, it is in their market, so why not have it here? What I am saying is that that is getting questioned. And people are saying that, okay, may I be there, is it suitable for me? Is that product itself a good product to have? So on. So these questions are being asked now more often, and there is no longer such a thing as conventional wisdom. I didn't discuss it for two reasons. One is that whatever there seems to be consensus among the regulators that they will mandate some kind of percentage to be kept by the originator in their securitization product regulations. So it appears that this point has been addressed. Into what happened in the US, it is not as if these products were not in the books of the entities that had originated them. So it is not as if they were not there at all. It is just that they had created vehicles, they were sitting somewhere else in that vehicle, but they didn't want to show it in their balance sheet. So this creation of a vehicle itself was called innovation. It was not innovation, it was just circumventing regulation. Because you didn't want the regulator to see it. AIG gave out so many CDS contracts. If they were on AIG proper balance sheet, then the insurance regulator would have seen it and they would have asked them, that where is the capital for this? You are effectively giving out insurance. So it's not as if these products were not sitting there. People had created vehicles and they had created a mirage that these don't exist. My balance sheet is healthy. That was the problem. Ex ante, in terms of quality of the loans that you give and what is your responsibility towards it, I think that issue will get addressed with the requirement that a certain percentage should be kept on the loans of the original. Thank you.
Thanks,
sir.
Discussing earlier this morning about the mutual funds and how to sort of grow it and all the policy changes. So two questions is, in terms of active demat accounts, individuals are holding, I think it might be say about 5 million or something, ballpark number. And in terms of similar number for holding mutual funds, I guess. Number of folios seems to be like exposure, a multiple, big multiple of that. So we want to see a sort of a 10x growth in it, given the size of the country and making our markets more relevant. What do we go about doing it? Do you have any thoughts?
I think we will have to focus on the cost of transaction. One of the problems that we have as a developing country is that while our number of transactions easily built in any system to levels that can be compared with the world, the individual ticket size is very small. And therefore, the cost that that transaction can bear is very small. And here, the innovation in terms of technology, in terms of things like Aadhaar that the government of India is looking at, if we constantly chip at this cost of transaction, then that will help us to bring in more people. And once they come in, they will, over a period of time, attain a size. But cost of transaction will be a very, very important issue for us. And we need to keep on driving attention.